Hi everyone, it's Emma here from My Vocal, and today I'm answering the question, why do my legs hurt when I get my period? So I think this is a slightly less common symptom of PMS or our monthly cycles, but it certainly can still affect some people, and it is a question that we are asked on the A-Vocal helpline quite routinely. So I'm just going to explore some of perhaps the underlying mechanisms, what could be contributing to this monthly symptom, and offer up some solutions, some advice as well. So the first reason that your legs can be sore around the time of your period is first of all down to prostaglandins. So these are very likely to be contributing if you experience the pain alongside your period cramps or alongside the kind of heaviest point of your period. So these prostaglandins are kind of chemicals that are released from the lining of your womb. They cause the lining of your womb to break down, which actually gives you your period. But what these chemicals do is they cause the womb to contract. And when the womb contracts, this can cause pain, and it can restrict the blood flow very slightly in a kind of cycle of constriction and dilation. So that's what contributes to that pain. Now, these prostaglandins are quite inflammatory in their nature. And that does create kind of inflammation around the site of the womb, but also this pain can spread slightly as well. So for many women who experience diarrhea around the time that they are getting their strong cramps in their womb, then this mechanism is occurring as these prostaglandins are kind of spreading through. The womb especially is very close to your large intestine, but these can spread a little further afield, and women might experience kind of crampy type pains in the tops of their thighs and their legs as well. So that's just one of the first reasons that this can give, that these prostaglandins, these inflammatory prostaglandins, can give rise to pain in the surrounding areas. Interestingly, there has been research to suggest that lots of lovely anti-inflammatory supplements, so your vitamin D and your omega-3 in particular, they are particularly anti-inflammatory, could actually help with the period pains specifically. So it's likely to be because of those inflammatory pathways. So those are two to consider if, as I've mentioned, the prostaglandins are likely to be contributing and you notice the pain is worse when your period is starting at that kind of heaviest time. So I'll put links in the description to the vitamin D and omega-3 research if anyone would like to read a little bit more about that. Moving on, we're just going to explore some of the different types of pain. So we have kind of joint pain that women might experience perhaps around their hips, or even down as far as their knees, but more likely, as I've said, in that vicinity of your womb, so perhaps your hip pain. Now, it's something to consider here that we would also want to consider any other underlying issues. So if anyone is suffering already from osteoarthritis or rheumatoid arthritis, for example, then what happens is we could just become more vulnerable at this time as your estrogen levels drop. So estrogen is very good for helping to keep our muscles and our joints lubricated. So as estrogen levels drop, this can often cause a flare-up in our symptoms. And this is something that is very common during menopause as estrogen level fluctuates, but then our monthly period is almost like a mini menopause. We are experiencing that crash in estrogen levels, which could potentially exacerbate underlying conditions or underlying weaknesses, so they just might flare up if your joints are a little weakness there in your system. So this drop in estrogen to give us our period, it's not something that we can really that we really want to majorly influence. This drop in hormones is natural to give us our period, and then the estrogen levels will start to rise towards ovulation again. But what I would say is to prioritise hydration. Hydration is absolutely key, and it can help to just offset very slightly the drops in estrogen and losing that protective hydrative functions. I'll go on to give a few more tips around the estrogen balance as well, just in a sec. Number three, I just wanted to talk a little bit about muscle pain. So when you experience the pain or discomfort, you might notice it in your joints or your muscles. So I want to talk a little bit about muscle pain as well, because we remember that the prostaglandins are directly affecting your muscles in and around the womb. So it is the muscles of the womb that are contracting, and these prostaglandins are very good for affecting the muscles and causing those muscles to contract. So as I've said, these prostaglandins can disperse a little bit into surrounding areas. So maybe that muscular pain perhaps in your thighs that you notice, and you're quite sure that the pain is muscular. In that situation, obviously hydration is very important, but I would prioritise the nutrient magnesium. If you feel that those muscle pains, muscle cramps are the main source of the pain for you. So I would recommend something like our balanced mineral drink. It contains a good dose of magnesium. So I usually recommend between 100 and 400 milligrams. This has also got your other nutrients such as your vitamin D in there. It's quite a nice all-rounder. If you wanted to just focus on a standalone magnesium, as I say, you could take up to 400 milligrams daily. So you might just want a standalone form of magnesium. Forms such as gluconate, citrate, those ones are particularly well absorbed, so those are the forms that I would look out for. Number four, I just want to touch on low estrogen in a little bit more detail. So as I say, the drop in estrogen to give you your period, that's to be expected. But if you are suspecting that you've got other low estrogen symptoms, either throughout the month and the lead up to menopause, your monthly cycle might is a little bit longer between this time between periods. Other low estrogen symptoms can often include low mood, quite dry, problem skin, just other symptoms. We talk a lot about this, and I can give you a link if you're looking for more information there on hormone imbalance. But if you're really wanting to support low estrogen and you feel that drop in estrogen is just exacerbating your symptoms, then I'm just offering some tips here. So hydration is number one, as we've mentioned. Your amygdala, really, really important. So when we talk about hydration and the drop in estrogen, the omegas can help to really hydrate us and nourish us from within. Omega 3, as I mentioned, would be one to consider. But if that dryness is an issue, and it can be hard to determine in your joints apart from the achiness, but if you've got dry skin, dryness down below, any other dryness, your hair, then omega 7 can be particularly nourishing. And as I say, it can often be quite relevant in cases of low estrogen. For further estrogen, more general estrogen support, a source of fermented soy isoflavones can be really helpful to help create support that estrogen balance on a bigger scale, more generally throughout the month. So you wouldn't just take something like this at the time of your period. That would be a longer course to help really support that those underlying hormones. And that's quite often quite opposite from the agnoscastis. So the agnoscastis would be supporting estrogen dominance symptoms usually. And again, if you need more help trying to determine if there is an underlying hormone imbalance, we have some blogs with further information there, which I will put in the description. Last point on my list here is just the potential that there could be some underlying conditions which we would always need your doctor to check. So particularly if the pain is quite severe around the time that you're having your period, and that's when you really notice the pain, and perhaps it's not just around your womb but leading towards your legs or other areas, there potentially could be something going on like endometriosis. And this is when parts of your womb fall outside, the lining of your womb fall outside your actual womb and can irritate the surrounding areas. So potentially that's where your legs or joint or muscle pain could come into this. That they have the potential to lie outside the lining and affect nerves in other areas in the surrounding areas, which potentially could travel down your leg. So as always, we would always just say that if your symptoms are particularly severe, persistent, or you're getting a wide variety of symptoms out with the norm to some degree, then we would always say just to double check with your doctor. So thank you everyone. I really hope that that's been helpful. As always, please do leave any comments or questions below, and we'll get back to you. Please also subscribe to our Avogel YouTube channel and also hit the bell icon so you'll be notified of any future videos. Thanks.